Hey YouTube, it's DarkHunter2121 and I'm here with 123 Invaders. And today we're gonna be reviewing Super 8.
And action!
I understand you have concerns about our cargo.
Colonel, there isn't anything else that I should know, is there?
I can assure you the answer is no.
I've got 9 people missing now. There are things happening around here that I can't explain.
I saw it. No one believes me.
I believe you.
What did you think of this movie?
I think this is one of the greatest modern films. It reminded me so much of the films that I grew up with, like E.T.
Yeah, a lot of... if you want to go towards that type of feel, you want to go for like an Iron Giant type feel to it. Like, I like this movie a lot. And just the way they filmed it, and with like the 80s theme and everything, which we'll talk about later on in this review. This is like one of the best films made within the past 10 years, I'd have to say. Which character do you relate to most from this movie?
I guess the main one.
Joe?
Yeah.
Yeah. I like Joe too, but I'm more like his friend who's like the more filmmaker with the film idea type guy. That's who I relate to more.
So did you feel that this... was a bit like E.T.?
I do feel this was a bit like E.T. with like the alien theme, with like having the giant alien in it.
It feels like E.T. if E.T. was psychotic.
It does feel like E.T., but more as George Lucas's directive, faster and more intense. That was pretty much this movie. Do you think this is one of the most original movies out there today?
Kind of.
This is definitely one of the more original movies. It has some themes of past movies, but this is one of the more original stories.
So what were your thoughts on the monster design?
I love the monster design, even though I think out of the modern movie monsters, it could be kind of like Cloverfield, the movie Cloverfield.
Like the first few times I watched the movie, I guess the screens I watched it on were really dark. I could never clearly see the monster until the last time I watched it, and it looks pretty cool.
Yeah, you got to watch it a couple times in order to see the monster. If you don't see it, then you could always just look up the monster from Super 8 on Google or something. What is your favorite scene from this movie?
I don't know. There's so many good scenes in this movie. I like the train wreck scene, even though it's... I think they overdid it with the explosions.
Okay, my favorite scene was the one at the gas station where the sheriff was just taken. And all the dogs just start running out. And the guy in the dude in the gas station is on the Walkman.
Yeah, that was a good scene.
Yeah, that was a really good scene. The way they did the lights in the gas station and everything, and the bell, the electronic bell, just keep going and going. Just, there were so much elements in that scene that were just so good.
Would you like to own a Super 8 camera?
I would love to own a Super 8 camera. Even though they're kind of, the film and everything's kind of hard to find now, it would be cool to have it just as a, just film history and the history of filmmaking. What do you think of the sets and costume designs in with the 80s theme?
It's awesome. It works so well in this movie.
The way they film, it looks like it's made now, and they make it look realistic, like set in the 80s realistic.
So do you think JJ should cut down on the lens flares?
I didn't see much lens flares on this
one. I mean, like in this one, no, there wasn't too many, but in his other movies.
Yeah, in his other movies, the only real lens flare movies he has, I don't know what he did in the show Lost, because I know he worked on that show, but in his movies, the only real lens flares one was the first Star Trek.
Oh yeah, the lens flares got annoying in
there. Yeah, and I hope he doesn't put too many lens flares in Star Wars Episode 7. Because that would ruin Star Wars, just so many lens flares. It's okay every now and then, but not too much. What would you rate this movie?
I'd give it a 9 out of 10 trooper helmets.
I'd give it, yeah, a 9 out of 10. That's a pretty good rating for this. This was a really good movie. A lot of this is one of those movies where you really got to study. If you're going into filmmaking and stuff, you really got to study the shots and everything, because you learn a lot from this movie. Other than that, thanks for watching and stay tuned for the next episode of Cinema Time.
Please check out our new sponsor, Dollar Shave Club. I use these razors myself, and they provide a perfect shave for 10 times less the cost in the stores. So check these guys out and shave time. Shave money.
Please rate, comment, and subscribe. And to view our previous video, it is on the top right-hand corner. And we have a mystery video for you guys on the bottom right-hand corner. And don't forget to watch Cinema Time on the Dark Hunter 2121 channel.